Hello and welcome to the first instructional video on how to properly submit a case on the AIRP case submission webpage. You should have received an email with login instructions after your registration. If not, or if you may have lost track of your login info, there's a hyperlink located right here where you will be able to retrieve your information after being directed to a different webpage. After you have logged in, you will be prompted to select the course for which you have registered for. You will be directed to the instructions page, which contains detailed instructions on how to properly prepare a case for submission, as well as a general overview of the case submission process. I would specifically like to point out the section labeled Best Case Award, which contains examples of cases that have won this award in the past. You will also be able to view the RADPATH correlation material submitted with these cases. Lastly, I would like to draw your attention to the American College of Radiology's Code of Ethics for your viewing purposes. This video will review the case data entry section of your case. All input boxes with asterisks must be filled out in order to confirm page requirements. In the diagnosis section, only the options provided from the drop-down menu may be used for the diagnosis, or you may check the box next to "I had trouble finding an accurate diagnosis for my case" from the drop-down list. The same goes for the drop-down list next to the differential section. If unsure about the differentials, please contact the section chief by email for recommendations. It is important to provide the address for the contributing pathology lab, which may differ from the contributing hospital. The address provided cannot be a PO box, it must be a street address. After the form is filled out and satisfies all of the requirements, make sure to click the Confirm Page Requirements box at the top or bottom of the page to ensure completion. The case data entry page is complete when a green check mark is visible next to the section after clicking the box. Lastly, the verification consent form should be printed, signed by the pathologist, and brought to the course you registered for. It will be collected at the course with your slides. This can be found next to the Confirm Page Requirements box. If you attempt to print the verification consent form and you have not completed the case data entry page, as well as submitted a pathology or autopsy report, you will be directed to this screen. You will have to fulfill both of those requirements before you are able to print this form. This video will review the Upload Documents section for the case submission process. All documents uploaded to this section must be original reports in PDF format. To comply with HIPAA regulations, it is mandatory that all personal health information, or PHI, be removed or redacted from all documents submitted. Please view our separate video on how to properly redact documents if there are any questions or concerns. In the Autopsy Pathology Report section, the specimen ID number for the case must be provided in the box with the asterisk. This same specimen ID number must also be present in the autopsy pathology reports. This number must be exposed in order to ensure case validity. An autopsy report or pathology report is required for submission, but if applicable, please provide both. The pathologist may assign an arbitrary specimen ID number, but it must match with the slides submitted at the course. To upload a redacted case report, select the Choose File box. Now select and click the Upload box. The file name will be presented in the section and a green check mark inserted next to the respective section when it has been completed. For international case submissions, complete English translations of the original reports are required in addition to the original reports. Once all required documents have been uploaded, there will be a green check mark located next to the Upload Documents section. This video will review the proper method for redacting personal health information, or PHI, from medical records required for this course. To comply with HIPAA regulations, it is mandatory that all personal health information be removed or redacted from all documents submitted. There are many methods that allow you to remove sensitive information from PDF documents. A common and straightforward approach would be manually whiting or blacking out sensitive information with whiteout or a permanent marker, and then rescanning the document and saving it as a PDF. In this instance, it is important to note that PHI is very sensitive, and sometimes this method may not completely obstruct or remove the information from view. Another redaction method is to use a file or image editing computer program such as Adobe Pro, Mac Preview, or another program that permits complete removal or obstruction of sensitive material. A detailed list of PHI examples are listed in the instructions section of the Upload Documents page on the case submission webpage. Please refer here for any questions. I will use Adobe Acrobat to redact an example pathology report and demonstrate what information should be removed to comply with HIPAA regulations. This video will review the Upload Images section for the case submission process. Detailed instructions are provided at the top of the page for any questions or concerns. All images uploaded on the page of the case submission website must be clean of personal health information, or PHI. All images must be submitted in JPEG format at the highest native resolution available. Editing images can be accomplished with a number of computer programs such as Microsoft Picture Manager, Adobe Photoshop, or any image editing software. As long as PHI is not visible and the image remains in JPEG format, the method of PHI removal is unimportant. In the radiologic images section, all images uploaded must be in the DICOM format. please review the supplementary video provided on the case submission website for assistance regarding DICOM upload. In the gross images section, a minimum of one image must be uploaded to complete your case. The gross images must be oriented to correlate the gross morphology of the disease with the radiologic findings. Images of the resected specimen or an autopsy are best suited for this purpose. However, intraoperative or scope images are also acceptable substitutions. Be sure to remove the specimen ID. Please review the example provided by clicking this link. In the histologic images section, a minimum of one image must be submitted as well. Make sure to submit all images individually and refrain from submitting them on a PowerPoint slide. Be sure to remove the specimen ID. Please review the example for histology provided by clicking this link. To upload an image, simply find the image you wish to upload and click the upload box. After you have completed all of the upload sections and you have checked that all of your images are present, consult the Available Imaging Modalities box and make sure the image types selected accurately reflect your submitted images. Be sure to review the Upload Images tab on the side of your screen and look for a green checkmark to ensure section completion. This video will review the process for uploading DICOM studies and series onto the Upload Images page of the case submission website. Detailed instructions are provided at the top of the Radiologic Images section on this page. You must first download Microsoft Silverlight if you do not already have this program on the computer you are using. There is a link in the Radiologic Images section that will direct you to a free download if needed. A complete case requires at least one full DICOM study. The order in which you upload the study is irrelevant as long as the whole study is present. When uploading DICOMs, it is recommended that you speed up the process by copying the images to your hard drive from a disk or jump drive. After the files are available on your hard drive, visit the Upload Images page in the Case Submission webpage and scroll down to the Radiologic Images section. To add a radiologic DICOM study, click here. I will now show you how to upload each series. Lastly, to ensure proper upload, make sure the number of uploaded files matches the number of expected files. If it does not, you need to delete the series and try re-uploading it. If in doubt of your study being uploaded in its entirety, please upload all of the series in the study rather than what you believe to be necessary. This is a tedious process, but a complete DICOM study is required for case submission. This video will review the case summary section for the case submission process. Detailed instructions are provided at the top of the page for any questions or concerns. The case summary page is a space to show RAD-PATH correlation of your case's diagnosis. Please review the blue text in General Image Requirements to assist in the completion of this section. For the images sections, you will select previously uploaded images from the Uploaded Images page. Select the images that best support the RAD-PATH correlation for the case. They must be clean of PHI. Here's an example for your viewing. Captions and annotations may be made by selecting the Edit or Annotate icons under the Actions column. Be sure to save when finished. Also, make sure the Available Imaging Modalities section accurately reflects the types of radiologic images you have uploaded. In the Discussion section, please complete all fields with an asterisk. Make sure to pay special attention to the faculty instructions above each box. In the Literature References section, three references are required for submission. All references must be either peer-reviewed journals or textbooks, and websites should not be referenced unless they are registries for the diagnosis. All references must be listed in English and in AMA reference citation format. To ensure completion, click the Confirm Page Requirements box at the top or bottom of this page. If this page does not meet the requirements, there will be red text informing you as to what is incomplete throughout the page. Finally, look for a green check mark next to the Case Summary tab on the side of the screen to be sure the requirements have been met. This video will review the Submit Case Package section for the case submission process. Your hard work has now paid off, and after completion of the previous sections, you will be able to submit your case. Start this process by ensuring all of the tabs on the side of the screen, except for the Submit Case Package tab, have been completed and that there are green check marks next to each. You will be asked to provide your current email address. This will be the email address that you will receive confirmation or any further information regarding your case submission and the course you have registered for. It is important that you provide an email address that you check on a regular basis. Next, please use the case submission checklist link located here to make sure you have completed all of the necessary steps in the case submission process. As you can see, the checklist is broken up into different sections of the case submission package. This is a very helpful list that will allow you to pick up on anything you may have missed. When all of the other check marks are present and you have reviewed the checklist, click the Submit box. As a reminder, after you finalize and submit your case online, you may access your pathology verification consent form from the case data entry page here.